They're still trying to ascertain the exact epicenter. They've been in contact with the National Earthquake Center in Golden, Colorado.
News reports commonly refer to an earthquake's epicenter. The word is a concept coined by Robert Mallet to help people visualize an earthquake's location. The epicenter is the map location on Earth's surface, above where the earthquake began. An earthquake actually begins inside the Earth at the hypocenter. The hypocenter ranges from several to hundreds of kilometers below the epicenter, in Earth's outer brittle layers. What do we mean by the earthquake begins? Let's place a grid on the strike-slip fault surface. A small earthquake releases energy at its hypocenter suddenly, like a blast of TNT. But an earthquake is not like a bomb. The area where the rock ruptured or broke is small, and the distance the rocks moved is small. A magnitude 4 typically ruptures about 1 square kilometer. A magnitude 6 ruptures about 100 square kilometers. Often, there is no surface faulting at the epicenter, but if an earthquake is shallow and the rupture area grows vertically, it may offset the ground surface or create a fault scarp. All earthquakes, including the largest earthquakes like this one on a subduction zone fault, began at the hypocenter. Seismic and heat energy are continuously released as the rupture spreads, as though it were unzipping the rough surface of the fault, sticking and slipping during the chain reaction. The earthquake stops when the fault stops slipping. Computers can make estimates of the hypocenter location within minutes or less, using the time of arrival of the seismic waves at seismic stations surrounding the earthquake. Again, the hypocenter is where it all begins, but the closest we humans can get is the epicenter.